So, O2, I'd like to talk about something. It's going to happen very soon. I'd like to talk about the EU referendum. I'm very, very interested in that. And what I'd like to do, I want to find out what people feel about it, but a bit of audience participation, a bit of market research. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to find out how you feel about it through the medium of the Okie Kokie. So we're going to sing the Okie Kokie. And if you want to stay in Europe, you obviously join in on in. And if you want to leave, you join in on out. Okay? It's that fucking simple. Could you get that wrong? Okay, I think we've got a good cross-section of British society here tonight. So I'll start it off. If you're not sure, just go... So we go, oh, okie kokie kokie. Oh, okie kokie kokie. Oh, okie kokie kokie. Knees, legs, arm, feet, rah, rah, rah. You put your left leg. Your left leg. You shake it all about. You do the okie kokie and you turn around. That's what it's all about. Very good. Well done, ladies and gentlemen. One more time, ladies and gentlemen. But this time, I think it's easier to say out than in. So in the interest of balance, if you want us to stay in, you say out. And if you want us to leave, you say in. You put your right leg...
In.
Your right leg...
Out.
See? I'm right, aren't I? It's easier to say out than in. I've learned something, and you've had a sing-song. I tell you one thing about this referendum. I think 16-year-olds should be allowed to vote, I really do, because it's their future. And I think 70-year-olds shouldn't, because it's not theirs. I think if you're over 70, put your pencil away and shut the fuck up. You've made enough of a mess, right, in your lifetime. You know, you leave another turd on the doorstep of the future. You fucked up the economy, the environment, housing, education, pretty much everything. They've even ruined Sunday night telly, haven't they? One of the few nights of the week I get to sit down and watch the telly, what have I got to watch? Country File, Call the Midwife, Mr. Selfridge. It's like being trapped in a nana's head. And this isn't a generation you should admire and respect. They didn't fight in a war. No, so fuck them. All they lived through is a couple of property booms. The only chance this country has got of staying in Europe is between now and June the 23rd, there's a cold snap. Or a hot one, we'll take either. Also, what I think is if we're going to have a referendum on that, let's have a referendum on a few things. Well, let's get a load of referenda out while we're doing it. Like, one of the things I want to have a referendum on is advertising to children. I want that stopped. I think that's something most of us agree on. We should have a referendum on it, right? Yeah? Because people come into my home uninvited through the medium of television and wave shiny shit in my kids' faces. And it's not fair, is it? Because we can defend ourselves against advertising, can't we? We can make judgments and choices. But children can't defend themselves against advertising because they're fucking idiots, aren't they? They're morons. They're thick as pig shit. If you put a picture of Shrek on a bag of gravel, they want it. It's true, you know? If all advertising was done door-to-door, you wouldn't tolerate it, would you? You know, if someone came... If you could only advertise door-to-door, someone knocked on your door, you opened it and they said, can I speak to your 7-year-old daughter, please? Bring her over. And he bends down, ignores you, and just goes, look, it's a My Pretty Polly Pocket mini vanity valise set. And that spins around, that opens up, and you send messages for your friend and you can collect characters up there. After a while, you go, fuck off. Sorry, Daddy said it again, didn't he? Well, you'll hear it at school soon enough. Or they will. Because there's always a source, isn't there? It'd be brilliant if all advertising was door-to-door, wouldn't it? It'd be fantastic, especially when celebrities did it, wouldn't it? It'd be great, wouldn't it? You know, if celebrities could only advertise door-to-door, you're walking across your hallway, your letterbox flips open, and you hear a voice on the other side.
Hello! It's Chris Hoy here. Before I go cycling, I like a bowl of bran flakes. Chris Hoy here. Before I go cycling, I like a bowl of bran flakes.
And he'd bump into other celebrities as he was doing the same street. Oh, hello, Kira.
Hi, Chris.
Hi, it's Kira Knightley here. Yes, from the films. No, I didn't think I needed the money either. Anyway, I'm wearing a really tight catsuit. Really, really tight. And when I walk away, I'd like you to look at my arse and think about Coco Chanel. Yes, it's very subtle. My arse and perfume.
Oh, hello, Ray.
Hello, Kira.
Ray Winston here. Put a bet on, you slag!
Oh, who's that coming down the street? Oh, it's David Beckham.
Hello.
Man of a thousand voices.
Hello, it's David Beckham here. Bloody hell. Just buy stuff. Just any old shit.
That's all from me. Thank you very much. Good night.